flat cars over here.
Idiots on the bikes. Three of them don't have shirts on. Riding their crotch rockets. Okay, two don't have shirts. One shirt guy has a helmet. One shirtless guy has a backpack on. Number one, do you want to have a tan like wearing a backpack? There's only one sensible one. Well, sort of sensible. He's still riding a crotch rocket. And they just split the lane. Two of them just split the lane. Now they're all speeding because it's only 35 and I can't catch them. So number one, they're probably doing 45 right now. They're almost up to the railroad tracks. That's another quarter mile away. I hate guys who ride crotch rockets and think they can, you know, think they're on top of the world. That nothing can happen. The shirt actually has a shirt on. He's basically on top of the damn zipper line. He is on top of the zipper line, which means he's encroaching into the other lane. Really? That wasn't a stop. Jesus. And there they go passing that car. Passing in a no passing zone. Holy crap! There was another car coming. He just split the lane. Idiots! Freaking idiots! I gotta go down that cross and get medicine. Now I'm gonna stop at Casey's and get something to eat because I'm freaking hungry. Cheaper. on yonder too. Huh. That side's on the right side, up here on the left, because there's a crossover right here that goes to the diverging route that goes south, and then goes south, south, and then goes southeast down to Hutchinson, Kansas. Oh, it ties into former ATSF, now WAMX. It read me clear back there before it got to the line. They're about done here. I think I'll pour some asphalt, or lay some asphalt. buffer cars back there. Looks like lumber is up. They got a lumber car up here as a buffer as well. Try to do in the truck. Of course, I won't be able to have 3 miles of siding, but the back of the sleeper will have 3 tracks, with the center track being the main line, and storage on either side of the main line. And then over the where the shelf is at, I'll have the sidings come down back into the main, and then they'll split back out, and I might just switch it up to where the 2 back tracks are storage tracks, and the front is the main line, and all I'm going to do is just switch cars back and forth. I'll take the empties that are out on the main, or out on the sidings, push them back into the loading docks, loading platforms. L-shape layout, switching layout. Or I could switch it up and have a whole bunch of yard tracks over the shelf, and the loading platforms all along the back wall of the sleeper, and just have one side loading, and then the front is the main line where all the loaded ones would go out. I might just do that instead. Staging tracks over the shelf that would have 4 or 5 tracks going down into a single line, and then right back into a siding that is actually the loading dock, loading platforms, going load from one side, and it'd be a stub ended, and then just pull them out and put them on the main, and then actually just, you know, stop the camera, take them off, and then have, you know, put them back up, as the next day would then they would be empty. Switcher would come in and pull some out. Oh, I'd have to create a runaround someplace so you can get behind them to shove them in the train yard into the staging tracks. Oh, that's it. Substation. Now another load of pipe. Hopefully, game plan is to get me back. I didn't call the boss, but he said, told the shop foreman there at Peterbilt to try to get me back Thursday evening, or if not Friday, and apparently the compressor is what's doing it. It's popping, or it's releasing air, and it's then actually forcing the antifreeze to come out of the side tank, which it's not even supposed to be at. Giant bass for a mailbox. There used to be a fish hatchery. Alright. Tracks over here. How's the little, where's that material distribution center? here in Topeka. Assuming this is the main line. That over there is a drag strip. Heartland Park, Topeka. Main entrance. There's quite a few different racetracks over there. You got the drag strip, quarter mile straight. I think there's a motocross and a circle track and a road race course. I'm gonna run back up here to the turnpike and mosey on over to Columbia, Missouri. quick shop. Those river tracks back there that we crossed, we get to, they get to cross us up here, overpass. Yeah, this is gonna make sense. We're gonna go up here, turn left, do a clover leaf back, go through the toll booth, do another clover leaf, and then head east. I could have, I guess, run up to 24 or 40. I guess I could have done that. But it's just kind of hard to do that from here. I'd have to go all the way back because Vega doesn't have a straight route no more. And I wouldn't want to, you know, these lights were okay. Any more lights, I wouldn't be cussing left and right. So here's the railroad tracks. This used to be US 75 until they put the bypass in, which of course links up to 470. I think that's the way you get the Army Reserve and Frito Lay. There's the turnpike above us there. Problems there. I do that about after I've made contact with people, but I know it doesn't affect me that quickly. Of course, there was. truck behind me. I went through the fast lane, he went through the medium fast, I guess. Just because we're getting you.